facility, no? Now, for today, hindi lang salamin ang special treat natin, no? May special treat tayo sa inyong lahat because we've invited one of the most sought-after speaker in our movement today. Alright? He is our pastor at Victory Fort sa Saturday service natin and in the Sunday 8 a.m. Since they started the 8 a.m. service, it is the most well-attended service of all. Okay, dahil napakagwapo nitong pastor na to. Alright, hindi siya gwapo. Hindi lang pala siya gwapo. Alright, kung hindi, you know, this man is really someone who loves God, who loves Jesus. And when he preaches, you would really feel the love of God in this man's heart and in his how he just preaches the word of God. You know, confession lang, no? Every time I would preach, some of you would say, ganda ng preaching, galing ng mga stories. Alam nyo bakit? Kasi sa Saturday service, naka-livestream yan, pinapanood ko muna si Pastor Jeff bago ko umakyat dito na, okay, so alam niyo na yung sikreto ko, baka sabihin niyo masyado ako magaling. Hindi, si Pastor Jeff talaga, no? Ang dami ko nakukuha kay Pastor Jeff. Just a man of God. Let's all give a warm victory greetings. Welcome to Pastor Jeff. All right.
Guys, before I start, ano, how many of you appreciate your pastor here? Ano, Pastor Dennis. Come on, bro. Alam niyo, sa totoo lang, ano, bata pa lang ako noon, nasa galeria ko, I always look up to this man. Hindi, bata ako sa pananampalataya. Okay? Keep praying for your pastors here. Of course, yung pastoral staff nyo rito, especially ngayon na meron kayong building project. I believe God is gonna provide. Thank you, Pastor Dennis. Alright! Good afternoon sa inyong lahat. Anong mga patay na tao rito? Ano dito? Mahihirapan tayo rito. Sa salamin lang kayo na buhay, ano? By the way, I'm really honored to be invited by Pastor Dennis. Last week, I was at Victory U-Belt where we all started. And this week naman, nandito ako sa Green Hills Church natin. I'm mas excited sa akin yung wife ko. I have my wife here with me kasi nalaman niyang Green Hills. Of course, shopping yan, di ba? So kanina, binigyan ko na siya ng... Pinaunahan ko muna, 100 pesos. Sabi ko, mag-shopping ka, bili mo lahat ng gusto mo. Tapos sabi ko, pagbalik mo, bili mo pa ako nung milk tea. May pabili pa eh, no? Sa lagay 100, ano? But I have my wife here with me and my two daughters. I don't know kung saan sila. Pinag-shopping ko, binigyan ko 100,000. Mamili kayo dyan. Yaman. Anyway, so, paano ba may start dito? I don't know. Pero masyado akong kinakabahan kanina because of, I don't know, baka yung pantalong ko butas, ginalamig or something. Ang hirap sundan ng salamin eh. No? I mean, yung mga pag-ganon-ganon nila eh. Parang gusto ko tuloy sumayaw ngayon. Ano? So, it's really an honor to be here. And we're now on our fifth series, ng fifth week ng ating series na All In. How many of you appreciate yung All In series? Come on now. Come on now. I mean, this is a very good book, powerful book to know kung ano, how rich you are in Christ. How many of you natapos mo na Ephesians? Ayan. How many of you here, kahit ano'y tanong ko, hindi ka magtataas ng kamay? Okay, meron. Alright. So we're in this series called All In because the whole idea, katulad na si kinanta ng mga salamin, kumbaga all in ka na kay Christ, di ba? Everything that we'll ever need, God has provided everything. Kumbaga, if you're playing poker, I don't know, meron ba naglaro ng poker dito? Di ba? Yung makikita ko sa Metro Walk ng mga to eh. Iba sa Resorts World Tambay to. Hindi, sa Facebook, right? If you're playing poker, the idea is pag sure ka na sa baraha mo, itaya mo na lahat, right? Because you're so sure, 100%, all in mo na. Diba sa inyo? Kahit misis mo, itaya mo. Ganun katindi pag sigurado ka. Yung iba, pag talo yung baraha, misis tataya. Huwag ganun, okay? Hindi tayo ganun. But the idea is, everything that we need is in Christ. God has given us everything that we'll ever need. Nung first week, pinag-usapan natin yung the blessing that we have in Christ. Can we flash that verse found in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3? It says here, tadaan! Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3. Ayan. Kukunin ko ang aking magic iPad. Okay? Ayan. Praise be to the God and Father of the Lord Jesus Christ who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with what? With few? With some? With what? With every spiritual blessing in Christ. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, hindi kuripot si God. Okay? Galante si Lord, di ba? Sabi mo sa katabi mo, ikaw lang kuripot, sabi mo. You see, everything that we'll ever need is in Christ. Okay? And I remember, so hindi katulad nitong si Alin Josie, sa si Junjun, mag-ina to eh, kuripot yung nanay na to. Sabi nun ni Junjun, Nay, pengin si kwenta. Sabi nun nanay, 40? Alin mo yung 30? Ang laki naman ng 20. Kala mo mahirap kumita ng 10, eto 5. Alam mo yun? Yung iba, naka-pensum 1, ngayon pala nag-gets. Okay lang, tawa na kayo. Alright. Good, okay, we're on the same page na. si Lolo Ron sa jeep pa mamaya magigets. Okay lang. Mag-isa kang tatawa sa jeep mamaya. But here's the point. We have everything that we need in Christ. Okay? All the blessing. Hindi siya kuripot. Not only that, He has given us the grace. We've sang a while ago, yung kanta ni Don Moen, "It's only by grace." We were dead. We were heading for destruction. We were disobedient and heading to hell. And yet, He has given us this grace, which is in the body of Jesus Christ, was pierced on the cross, and then naging possible po yung masagip tayo, and we were given life. Did you know that God did not reveal His Son to us so that we may be good from being bad? That's masyadong mababaw yun for a purpose of sending His Son. We can be good, hello. Magaling nga tayo for being good eh. But God sent His Son to die for us so that from death you will have life. Not that from bad you will be good. No. From death, you will have life. And not only that, the mystery was revealed to us on the third week. Knowing that we were once aliens, we were once Gentiles, without Christ, without hope, lahat ng without. Without citizenship, without security, without sense of significance, without. And then He formed this body of Christ, which is what we call church. Pinag-isa niya, there is no more Jews, no Gentiles, no Greek, no slave, no lahat pinag-isa niya. And that's what we call the church. And Jesus Christ being the head. You follow? That's what the mystery is all about. It has been revealed. And last week, who preached here last week, Pastor Dennis? Ikaw? Pastor Dennis shared to you about our role corporately. Now that we are called into this body we call church, we have to protect at all costs. We have to keep the unity in the body of Christ. In doing so, not only we keep the unity, but we also serve the body. That's why we're involved in every ministry. But of course, we have only one ministry, and that's the ministry of reconciliation. Because we have a message of reconciliation, the Bible says. And in doing so, you will be mature, not being tossed back and forth by every waves na marinig nyo, because you're founded on the truth. And today we're going to talk about individually what's our role. If our role as a church is to protect and keep this unity, to serve the ministry, and eventually grow, now what's our role? That's what we're going to study today. We're going to talk about living the life that is focused on love. Living a life of love. At pag-uusapan po natin yan, we're going to look at this verse found in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 to 2. But before we go through that, kwento lang, konting background lang. Baka akala nyo, nasa Ephesians, yun lang yung kwento ng Ephesians. No, you can find the Church of Ephesians, yung history niya, hello, mga kaibigan ko, nandito pa. You can find those kwento in Acts chapter 19, okay? In Acts chapter 19, you can see this church na Ephesians, nung pinlant ni Paul. This was like around 51 to 55 AD. Okay? Meron na bang nabuhay nun? Wala na si Pastor Tito. Si Pastor Tito kasi meron yung ano eh. Ay, wala si Pastor Tito. Pwede natin okra yan. Okay? Kanina, medyo pigil ako eh. Meron yung Fountain of Youth eh, si Pastor Tito. So, nabuhay na siya nun. Nakashort pa mga police nun and all. Black and white pa mundo nun. 51 AD eh. Okay? Okay? May mga dinosaur pa nun. But here's the point. Paul started that ministry. And it was such a powerful ministry in church established doon. The Bible says every Greek and every Jew in the province of Asia heard the word of the Lord. Heard the word of God. So silang passionate in sharing the Bible, in sharing the word, in sharing their testimony. Not only that, because of that, there was a great riot. You recall Acts chapter 19? Yung mga Bible niyo ba, naka-plastic pa sa bahay? Alam niyo yung pagka babasahin mo lang, talaga mamamatay ka na. Ha, anak, kunin mo yung Bible, yung ginamit sa kasal namin noong 1974. Kunin mo. Dadalhin dito, yung may plastic, okay. Ha, bakit? May problema ako. Buksan mo ko ano man sinasabi ron. Tingnan mo, anak, pagbukas ni Junjun. Pag dad, ito, and Judas hung himself. Ano tayo? Yung panabasa nyo because you're not reading your Bible. Hello? Ha? Oo, nandun yun sa Acts chapter 19. There was a riot in Ephesus. Because they're propagating this new belief na si God and you can receive Jesus, nawala na negosyo itong sila Demetrius, yung silversmith. Yung ginagawa nila mga Diyos-Diyosa na Lady Diana, na sexy, hindi na bumibenta. So there was a riot, pinakulong sila, but then the Bible says extraordinary miracles are happening in the Church of Ephesians. So that's how powerful this church was. 3 years, umalis na si Paul, and then after 6 years, you follow, this was like around 9 to 10 years na yung church, he wrote this Ephesians. Sinulat niya to sa mga taga-Ephesus para i-encourage sila. So, are we on the same page? Ngayon, babasahin natin ngayon yung sinusulat ni Paul doon sa 10-year-old church na in-start niya, was propagating, was powerfully, God is moving in the midst of that church. Can we all stand as we read the Word of God found in verse 1 of chapter 5? If you don't have your Bible with you, I believe it's time to buy your Bible. Okay. Kung wala, magkunwari kang may binabasa sa katabi mo, Huwag mo lang i-highlight, okay? Nakikibasa ka lang eh. Okay. Verse 1, be imitators of God. Can you say it with me? Imitators. Be imitators of God, therefore, as dearly loved children, and live a life of love. So God was telling these Ephesians, Paul was telling, live a life of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Let's just pray. Father, we thank you for the reading of your word. Father, we pray today as we all together learn, Lord God, the truth based on what Paul has written to this church in Ephesians. Lord, may you just grasp, give us the wisdom to grasp the truth, Lord God. Give us the wisdom of understanding, Lord God, so that we will be able to apply it in our lives. Lord, steer those hearts, those hardened and callous hearts to receive your word tonight. Lord, use me powerfully. Holy Spirit, please use me as we all together learn from this book in the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, pwede na po tayo maupo. Alright, let's talk about imitation first. Ayan, Green Hills, the land of imitation. Okay. Okay. Meron bang may pwesto dyan sa Tiangge? Okay. Ano tawag doon? Hindi to fake, okay? Original to. 2-5 yan. So, may presyo pa eh, no? The word imitation means, the Greek word of imitate means mimetes. Wow. Mimetes. Wow, ang sarap i-tweet niyan, ano? May bago kang word, mimetes ka. Pero ang meaning yan is an imitator. That's where we got the word mimic. Okay? And God was telling this, and Paul was telling these people in Ephesians, imitate God. Okay? Be imitators of God. I don't know about you, but your very lifestyle reflects who you are imitating, right? Come to think of it, the brand that you're wearing today, I don't know, the brand of shirt, the shampoo that you're using today, you are influenced by the person na ini-imitate mo. Eh, siyempre si Papa Piolo, nasa BDO. Ay, mag-BDO na rin ako, baka maging kamukha ako si Piolo. And, si Casey, yung ginagamit nyo ngayon shampoo, kaya ka nag-switch sa Palmolive from Gugo, kasi, wow, baka maging kasing ganda ako ni Casey. Right? We are being influenced, one way or the other. Look, kahit yung mga may edad dito, wala na akong ini-imitate. Well, really? The way you talk, the way you dress, there's something na ini-imitate ka that influence you. Sa mga kabataan, madali. I mean, yung mga kaedad namin, of course, mga salamin, hello, mga ini-imitate, Justin Bieber, hello, may mga believer ba in the house? Come on now! Hindi nyo inabot yung hair ko eh. I'm a believer, by the way. So, there's something that we look up to because we want to imitate and it reflects our very lifestyle. And come to think of it, even your parenting style, and most likely tayo po nakahawa tayo, we imitate our father. Tingnan nyo, the way you parent your children are the way you have been parented by your parents, right? Kung passive ka sa mga anak mo, ganun ka pinalaki ng magulang mo, most likely, most especially yung tatay mo. The way you treat your spouse is based on paano mo nakita yung tatay mo, paano ba niya i-treat yung nanay ko nun? And most likely, whether you like it or not, maybe may times na hindi mo ini-imitate yung mga ginawa niya, same thing, you've been influenced. Hindi ko gagawin yung ginawa ng tatay ko sa nanay ko. You have been influenced by your dad. There was a story, one time, si Junjun, okay, pinatawag yung tatay sa, ano, si Mandelpin, pinatawag sa principal's office. Mr. Pakundo, Gadalaplido, yung anak mo, tuwing po naming papagalitan, lumalabas ng kwarto. Tumayo si Mandelpin. Hindi totoo yan, ha? Hindi ganyan yung anak ko. Tapos lumabas. Ah, okay. 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 Sabi ng principal, okay, alam na natin kaninang galang nagmana. Okay. But this is the point. If your son or your daughter is acting like a monkey, guess what? There's a gorilla in the house. Come on now. There's a bigger monkey in the house. Because our father influences a lot. Our parents influence us a lot. I'll show you this picture. Mahilig ako sa shades nung araw. Of course, na-idol ko si Randy Santiago. So I have this picture. This is like 14 years ago. This is my daughter. Sa isimit yun, hindi ako yan. Oh, hindi pa lang ako nakakakain na masarap niyan. Kaya medyo, and of course, I'd like to thank Bello for my, nakakapagpa-facial na rin ako niyan. Ay, mga pastor din kasi, baka kala niyo, Holy Spirit, nagpapaganda. Facial yan. So, baka i-question ninyo yung itsura ko noon. Yan yung daughter ko. This is like 14 years ago. Ginagaya niya ako noon. So, si Shades din siya. Na-influence ko rin siya. And not only that, some of you here, yung katawan, okay? Yung mga itsura nyo, parang ganito yung itsura nyo, mag-ama, oh. Parang mga sitting Buddha. Can you show that picture? Ayan. Ayan. Magkamukha na, oh. Ano? Ang cute, ano? Or iba sa inyo, the way ka matulog, na-influence mo yung anak mo, ah. Ayan. Kaganun pa talaga eh, no? Or sometimes, yung mga bad habits natin, unfortunately, pati bad habits natin, nagagaya. Yung umiinom at nag-ano, Yossi, ayan o, bata pa. And of course, yung mga tattoo-tattoo na yan, eh, ayan, ako, puro tattoo yung bata. Nakakalungkot naman to itsura na to. But the point is, our lifestyle reflects who we imitate. And that's why Paul was pounding on the Ephesian church, be imitators of God. Ngayon, the question is, in what sense, in what attribute, in what character ni God? I mean, yung omnipresence ba niya? We know God is omnipresence. He can be anywhere at the same time. Some of you, ganun kayo, di ba? May small group ng Wednesday, may Bible study ng Tuesday, may victory weekend, may... Lahat kayo, nandito na kayo lahat sa church. Kala ko nga full-time na kayo, eh, no? Kahit saan makita kayo. Iba naman, kung nasa'y crush mo, andun ka. Hey, alam niyo yan? Ginagawa niyo, evangeligaw. Iba, disciple chicks. Mapapansin niyo yan eh, pag kumakanta yan ng worship song. I worship you, my God. Katabi yung crush niya. I worship you, my God. I love you. I love you. Ganun ang mga dating niyan eh. Alam mo, disciple chicks ginagawa sa church. Hindi ganun. Gagayahin natin, we're gonna imitate God in the area of how He loves. How God loves us. And I'm gonna pound this to you so that sumaksak sa isipan natin that we can live a life of love just like the way God loves us. How did He love us? Una-una, He called us to be His son. He adopted us to be His son and daughter. And not only He adopted you as son and daughter, He called you by name. He knows your very name. He knows the number of your hair. Some of you here, hindi mahihirapan si God. May isa doon. Yung mga BMW. Ano yan? Buhok mo wig yun. Ibig sabihin na. So anyway, the point here. Okay, minsan lang naman ako nandito. Pagbigyan niyo na ako. How did He love us? Na He not only adopted us to be His son and daughter, but He called us beloved. Alam niyo ba yung word na beloved? Sa Tagalog, pinakamamahal. I don't know kung nag-sink in na sa utak mo to. The creator of heaven and earth, the one who created all things, the one who commanded the sea, the one who commanded everything to come into life, the one who's above all, the one true God, called you beloved. Pinakamamahal kong Dennis, pinakamamahal kong Cynthia, pinakamamahal kong Grace, pinakamamahal kong Tina, pinakamamahal kong Jeff. You know kung sino in-address lang ni God na ganon? Ng beloved? Let's look at this verse found in Matthew 3:17. He was this particular incident was Jesus was nabaptized. Sabi ni God, and behold, a voice from heaven said, "This is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased." The way God addresses His very own son, Jesus Christ, who are addressing us at the same level. Beloved son, I know you by name. I know what you're going through right now. Alam ko yung cancer na pinagdadaanan mo. Alam ko yung difficulties sa marriage na pinagdadaanan mo ngayon. Alam ko yung struggle mo with pornography right now. Alam ko yung struggle na pinagdadaanan mo. Let me tell you something. I am with you always. Because I love you. And not only I love you are my beloved son and daughter. That's how He loves us. That's how we're gonna imitate Him, that kind of love. Maybe you're saying, baka verbal lang naman yan. No, He proves it. Look at this verse. I'm gonna show you a verse in John 15:13. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. Anybody here, you're willing to give up your life for your wife, for your spouse? Ako, willing ko ito yan, buhay ko sa misis ko. Sa mga anak nyo, willing kayong bigay yung buhay mo, di ba? For someone you love. I remember a story one time, nasa ER. Ito magkasawa to eh. Si Aling Josie sa si Mandelpin eh. Nasa ER, naghihingalo na yung babae. Delphine, nahihirapan ako huminga. Eh kung nahihirapan ka, itigil mo na. Huwag mong labanan. Sabi ng asawa, huwag mong labanan. Itigil mo na yung paghinga na yan. Okay. Okay, naikwento na, natawa na. Okay. Okay, we're on the same page na tayo. Na, hindi katulad nun. Eh, one time, bumawi yun eh, si Aling Josie. Sabi niya, "Delphine, mahal mo ba talaga ako?" "Oo naman, honey. Kapati buhay ko, willing ko ibigay sa'yo." "Heh, puro kasat-sat, di mo gawin." Okay. Joke yun. Okay, pwede na tayo ngayon. Okay, sabay-sabay na tayo. Bumabaha, humihina, Dennis to, mahina to. Mas maganda response sa kabila. Ha? Mga taga-dating daan yata to. Anyway, seryoso eh. Greater love is no one than this, that you're willing to give up your life to one's friend. But the ironic thing is, we were not even friends with God. We were enemies by God. We were spitting in His face. Face to face, we were disobedient to Him. We were disobedient. We were enemies. We're not even friend with God. But look at this verse, Romans 5:8. Para maintindihan nyo itong i-imitate natin. Romans 5:8, but God demonstrate His own love for you. While we were still sinners, while we were still disobedient, while we were still enemies of God, He sent His Son to die for you. Have you ever grasped that truth? Church, this is the love that we're going to live out. This kind of lifestyle. Loving. That is not pakabig, but give, pabigay. For God so loved, past tense. For God so loved the world that He, what? Come on, yun lang ang favor, yun lang ang kabisado yung verse, hindi nyo pa kayo sumagot. For God so loved the world that He gave. Very good. Yun lang alam yung verse, eh. John 3:16 eh. Iba sa inyo, iba pang ibig sabihin. Here's the point. Look at this verse. Ephesians 5:1-2, the Message Bible. You sometimes, basahin yung mga Message translation, mas nahihimay, ibang approach. Watch what God does, and then do it. Like children will learn proper behavior from their parents, mostly what God does, listen to this, is love you. Keep company with Him and learn a life of love. Observe how Christ loved us. And next verse, His love was not cautious. Hindi po parang mamahalin kita, baka mamaya saktan mo lang ako, hindi kita mamahalin. No, no, no. The love of Christ is extravagant. He didn't love in order to get something, that's where most of us, baka big, from us, but to give everything of Himself to us. Sabi niya, love like that. That's what love, that's a picture of love that we have to imitate. There may be an office mate na asar-nasar ka. Ayaw mo i-share yung gospel, baka masay, baka makita mo pa sa langit. Help us, pinagdirasal ko nga, mamatay yan, sa impyerno siya. Hindi nagbayad ng utang, nagpaluwagan kami, tinakbo, mamatay na sana siya, alam mo yon? No, we have to love like that. Your enemies, you don't deserve heaven. We all deserve death. But then God sent His Son to die for you. I don't know about you, kung nag-sink in na to sa maliit nating utak, that God sent His Son and showed His love. That way, when we were still enemies, kinuha niya tayo. I'm gonna love this guy. Alright, mukhang mahirap, ano? That's why the problem is, mahirap to. Mahirap tong ganitong klaseng love. That's why, kailangan niyang ibigay lahat, kaya yung chapter 1 to 3 ng Ephesians is that everything that we need in Him. That's why you can do this chapter 4, 5, and 6. Ephesians 5:25, husband, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave Himself up for her. This is a kind of love. Yung mga may husband dito, no? Papatay mo na yung ego mo, papatay mo na yung pride mo for your wife. Yung misis ko one time, nagyaya. Eh, alam mo naman kami, mga lalaki, macho, mga action movie, mga gusto namin, di ba? Ayaw namin ng mga taga-Tagalog. Excuse, ano, pero, you know, I can't relate in the Tagalog. Well, nagyaya to, Bilma Santos. I'm not against Ate V, no? Bilma, John Lloyd, Lucky. Ha, baka may makakita sa akin, papasok ako sinihan, di nagtatakip akong ganyan, ano? Baka i-tweet agad, Pastor Jeff, in Bilma movie. Naku! So, nagpalit talaga ako ng mukha, nagpapangit ako, hirap na hirap na akong gawin yun eh. So, iyabang. Hirap na hirap ako. So pagpasok namin, pinagbigyan ko lang, pinatay ko yung pride ko, yung ego ko. But daw, alam mo pinakamasakit doon, sa totoo lang, ito totoong reason eh. Bilma yun eh. Noranya na po eh. Yun ang problema ron eh. Parang ano sa amin yun. Mortal sin yun. But the point is, you have to die to your wife. Love Him as Christ loved the church, who gave Himself everything. Who gave everything. A lot of us were conditional lover. Hindi part-time lover, okay? Conditional lover tayo. Mamahalin kita, pero gawin mo to. Mahalin kita, secure my future ko. Mahalin kita, pero pagbigyan mo ko. Everything in this world is conditional. Bigyan mo ko ng iced tea na yan, bayaran kita. Every transaction here is conditional. Kaya nga, iba tong love ni God. Mahirap to, apart from grasping this truth, na He loves you so much. He sent His Son to die for you. Na you were headed for hell, and then kinuha ka niya. Na you call yourself a Christian, we should love like that. Seryoso. Now, anong picture na tong living a lifestyle of love? There's no hint of sexual immorality. Verse 3, but among you there must not even be a hint of sexual immorality or of any kind of impurity, of greed, because these are improper for God's holy people. You know what? This love is meant to be exclusive. It's just between you and your husband. It's just between you and God. Pagka sinabi niyang, there's no hint, a picture of a life living in a life of living in a life of love, it's a picture walang sexual immorality. Alam niyo yung sexual immorality? Well, to show you some illustration, fornication. It's sex before marriage. Adultery, sex outside the boundaries of your marriage. Pornography. More than any time in history, ngayon po napakahirap labanan na to. Because anywhere you go, I mean, you look at the, kasi from our place, sa we live in Cainta, papunta sa office namin sa Fort, isang katutak na billboard. Hindi ko maintindihan. Excuse me sa mga nag-advertise, ano? Ang ina-advertise, chinelas, yung babae nakahubad, tapos wala kang makitang chinelas. Okay? Ina-advertise, gulong ng kotse, pero yung babae nakahiga sa kali, ano ba ito, sa gasaan ba ito, ano? Bakit katawan yung nakikita rito? Because sex sells. No, tinan nyo ito, tinan nyo mga nangyari, because of this sexual immorality, National Statistics Office, out of 1.7 million babies that born in 2004, 8% of this, or 136,000, came from mga nanay between age 15 to 19. Do we have that slide? 136,000 babies in 2004 came from a mom na 15 to 19 years old. 15 anyos, nanganganak na. Hindi kasal yung karamihan dito. And even kasal, naghihiwalay. Yung bata, lumalaki rin. Hindi natin alam kung ano. And not only that, the statistic shows that every year, 64,000 teenagers committed abortion. 64,000. Nakakalungkot. And we call our country the only Christian nation in Asia. And not only that, HIV cases from statistics office ng DOH report 6,016. HIV, okay, wala na naman si Pastor Tito, no? Hindi to hair is vanishing, ano? Ano talaga to, yung HIV cases to, okay? 6,016 cases since 84 to 2010. Let me tell you something. Sexual immorality, there's no room for that in a Christian world. You see the illustration here. You know the scotch tape, pag dinikit mo yan sa isang surface, hindi na siya magiging sticky ulit to another surface. It's a picture when you got intimate with somebody else na hindi pa kayo kasal. You'll never enjoy that intimacy pag kinasal ka na. And scientifically, it's proven, pag multi-partner ang babae o ang lalaki, there's something na nangyayari sa system niya na hindi na siya makakonek, hindi na siya makarelate to somebody else the way na dapat dinesign ni God. Because sex is meant to be exclusive in the boundaries of marriage. Verse 5, for this you can be sure of this, no immoral, impure, or greedy person, such a man is an idolater. You see, idolatry, what idolatry does, alam niyo ba opposite ng love? Hindi hate, ano? The opposite of love is lust. And what idolatry does, ini-imitate niya yung passion, ini-imitate niya yung happiness, ini-imitate niya yung joy, only to find out, fake pala sa huli. Alam, I don't know about you, pero if you have kung may LB ka na bag na galing Green Hills, ano, the worst thing na mangyayari, ang nakakahiya lang naman sa fake na bag, okay, nasa party ka, yung mga amiga mo, ay, ang ganda-ganda na bag mo. Pagtingin niya, LV, pero sa bandang likod may LA, ba't naki A yun? Ano, Legazpi Alba yata gawa yan, ano? Nalaman nila, ja fake. Okay, naka-Rolex ka. Okay, gusto mo maging in sa Rotary Club, di naka-Rolex ka. Talaga nga, anong oras na ba? Ganon ka lagi, ganon. Pero ja fake yung Rolex mo, ha? Eh masama, kumulimlim. Kumulimlim pa lang, nagtubig na. Ganon yung mga ja fake eh. Makulimlim lang sa labas, nagtutubig na eh. The worst thing na mangyayari, mapaya ka lang sa mga kabarkada mo, di ba? Sa kumari mo, kumpare mo. Yun lang consequence nun. Pero come to think of it, the other day, I was watching this news. Meron pala mga ja-fake na rin na contact lens. Nakapanood niyo yan? Bumili yung isang dalaga sa Divisoria, sa lugar ni Pastor Dennis. Bumili ng apat. Iba-iba itsura niya. Okay, mukha siyang musang sa Monday, mukha siyang alakdan sa Tuesday, mukha siyang dinosaur na Wednesday, mukha siyang leopard ng Thursday. Pagdating na Friday, nandun sa ophthalmologist kasi namamagha yung mata. Hindi pala makahinga yung mga iris or whatever. Hello? Hindi makahinga. I don't know, pero if you're taking imitation like that, may consequence sa health mo. I don't know if you use mga fake na imitation na mga glutathione whatever, may consequence po 'yan physically. But you see, if you're thinking your motivation is love, and it turns out it's being imitated by idolatry, by lust, eternal po yung consequence. What is idolatry, by the way? It's anything you place before God. You're trying to draw that sense of satisfaction. You're trying to draw that sense of significance. You're trying to draw that sense of security from created beings, from created things. Kala mo masasatisfy ka pag naging boyfriend mo to. Kala mo masasatisfy ka pag naging girlfriend mo to. And you're into this illicit relationship thinking that this can provide you that joy. Only to find out pagdating, hindi pala, ibang partner naman. That's a problem with sexual immorality. Because those idolatries, we call that functional savior. It functions as a savior, but at the end, when the time comes, we're gonna give an accounting to God. Okay, sorry, mali yung ano mo, hindi love yung motivation mo. Ching! Eject. Diretso ka sa impyerno. Ha! So, wag po tayo madala sa ganon. Verse 3, don't allow love to turn into lust. Setting off a downhill slide to sexual promiscuity. Okay? Filthy practices and bullying greed. You know the difference between love and lust? I'm gonna show this quote from Edwin Lewis Cole. Isa po siyang author. Love desires to benefit others. Listen to this. Love desires to benefit others. Yan po yung love. Binebenefit yung iba at the expense of self. So, hindi siya self-centered. Because love desires to give. Ito naman yung picture ng lust. Lust desires to benefit self, baliktad, ano? At the expense of others because lust desires to get. If you want to live a life of love, better make sure every relationship that you have right now, ang goal mo is to give. Whether it's a parent-mom relationship, whether it's a husband-wife relationship, whether it's a boyfriend-girlfriend relationship, your desire is to give. Kaya kung meron kang boyfriend na hindi always, parang gusto lang yung may gusto lang sa'yo, makuha, ay hindi love yun. That's lust. Now, what do we have to do? Knowing that, as we start here, Paul was telling, imitate God in the way He loved. He loved you, He calls you beloved, He sent His Son to die for you when you were still enemies, binigay niya. And not only that, ang picture niyan is there's no sexual immorality, there's no impurity, there's no greed in this lifestyle that we have to live out, this life of love. And not only that, God, and Paul was imposing this. He's giving this instruction. Number one, do not partners with them. Tayo pa ng mga Christian, sabi, therefore, do not be partners with them. Huwag kang pumartner sa mga sexual na immoral. Let me just tell you something here. Hindi mo alam, pastor, may asawa na nga ako, pero yung palay na lumalapit sa manok. Well, unang-una, hindi ka manok, okay? So may problema na tayo ron. For the sake of discussion, let's say manok ka. Pag nahuli ka ng misis mo, tinolalabas mo, di ba? Delikado ka rin, okay? I don't care kung sino lumalapit, kung palay o manok. But the point is, may asawa ka na, enjoy that intimacy with your wife. You do not partner with those kind of people. If you're a young woman here, let me tell you something. Yung mga kabataang babae rito, did you know your identity before God? Sabihin mo sa mga katabi mo na dalaga, you are a princess. You are a princess. The Bible says in 1 Peter, we are a royal priesthood. Oh, tama na, pati lalaki, sinabihan ng princess. Babae lang. You are a princess. Listen up here. You are a daughter. Not only a daughter, you are a beloved daughter of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Did you know that? So do not partner with them. Kung may boyfriend ka, listen to this. Kung may boyfriend ka na sinasabi, i-prove mo yung pagmamahal mo sa akin, ibigay mo yung hinihingi ko. You don't have to prove that because alam mo, kung yan ang gusto mo, well, I've been intimate with my God. I am intimate with my relationship with my God and I know that He loves me. So hindi ko kailangan patunayan sa'yo na mahal kita. You tell to your boyfriend na nangungulit sa'yo, better wait and better treat me like a princess because I am a beloved daughter of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You better wait because I'm worth the wait. I'm worth the wait. I'm worth of every day of your waiting. Did you know that? Ang mga kabataan ngayon, binigay na lahat. Kaya pag-asawa mo na, wala ka ng alas. Kaya tatapak-tapakan ka na lang. It's hard, but it's true. Nabobola ka because akala mo love, it's lust. In this world that we're living in where everything is instant, we want instant gratification. We want instant, everything is instant. But you have to learn how to delay that gratification. You better wait because I am worth the wait. If you are a young man here, you are a prince. You are the beloved son of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. If somebody is offering you cheap thrills, ah, tingnan mo to, may bagong pornography site, free lang. Don't settle for that. Hello, screen lang yan. Settle, wait for the time ibibigay sa'yo ni Lord na yung partner mo, na pagiging partner mo for life. I understand some of you here, you've been praying for the longest time you're a single person. Alam mo yung picture ng mga single, yung speaking in tongues niyan, siya na nga. Eh, nakaedad na, no? Pwede na yan. Sawang-sawa ka na, namamasyal ka sa promenade, ang ka-holding hands mo, sarili mo. Okay? Ang tagal mo ng ka-holding hands sa sarili mo, uupo ka sa choking, sa may glass, kakwento mo yung sarili mo. Basta ka na. Pag wala ka magawa, tabihan mo yung sarili mo sa salamin, okay, mag-jack and poy ka hanggang kung sino matalo. It's worth the wait. He who finds a wife, finds what is good, and finds favor from God, you better wait. And young woman, you're meant to be pursued. The Bible says, he who finds a wife, you're meant to be pursued. Hindi ko'y nangahabol na lalaki. He who finds a wife. Not only we don't partner with them, but find out what pleases the Lord. Next verse, find out what pleases the Lord. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Leave us children of light. Verse 9, for the fruit of the light consists in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. And last verse, and find out what pleases the Lord. In every relationship that you're gonna go, in every relationship that you're gonna form, will this please my Lord? Lord, I'm entering into this relationship right now. Will this please you? Or maybe some of you here, you're in an illicit relationship, and you know that this is not pleasing to the Lord. Let me tell you something. Before kalad ka rin yan ng lalaki o babae na yan sa impyerno, you better tell him, let's stop this. Because I want to please my God. I want to please my God who loves me, who call me by name, who knows even the numbers of my hair, who has a plan for me not to harm me, but to give me hope and a future. But the problem is we always tend to forget that God loves us so much. Not only we are called to pursue, and we're not called to not to partner, but to please, and lastly, to expose them. 5:11 have nothing to do with them, with fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them. You see, tayo na nasa light. We were once in darkness, and we're called into the light, right? Nasa dark side tayo. Hello, mga nasa ano tayo ng mga Star Wars. Nasa dark side tayo. And when we met Jesus Christ, who is the source of life, who is the light, suddenly we turn into the light. And as a children of light, the Bible says in Matthew 5:14, you are the light of the world. Tayo, the disciple of Jesus, we are the light of the world. We are to expose them. Those people na nasa surrounding mo, yes, we're not called to partner with them. Do not get equally yoked with unbelievers. But we're not called na parang dead mahin mo na lang. No. We're called and we're meant to be the light. There are many darkened offices right here in the world. There are many dimly lit campuses in this world. There are many madidilim na surrounding in this world. Dimly lit marriages that need a light. And you are called to be the light. Alam nyo kasi nangyayari sa ano, the light reveals the truth and exposes the true character of things, right? Pagka nalinawan, kunyari, madilim to kanina, pag nailawan, okay, may speaker pala rito, hindi ka matitisod. It exposes the real thing. Kaya nga may mga ini-invite ka, kamag-anak, kaibigan, pag dinala, ay, punta tayo ng church, ay, ayoko dun. Takot na takot. Pag binilabasan mo ng Bible, ay, nako, Diyos ko, wag yan. Takot sila sa Bible, takot sa church, because they know deep inside them, mali yung ginagawa nila. And it will be exposed. But you just hang on there. We're not just called to enter heaven. Alam niyo ba na hindi ka lang tinawag para mapunta ka sa langit? That's part of the package. Pero if that's the only reason why God called you, dapat nung water baptism mo pa lang, nilublub ka na ng mga 20 minutes si Pastor Dennis. Pretend mo nga, kulay violet na ba? Hindi pa. Humihinga-hinga pa yung mata eh. Lublob mo pa. If the only reason why you got born again is to go to heaven, masyado mababaw yun. When Jesus first called his first disciple, sabi niya, come follow me. What do you expect? I'll make you a better husband. No, come follow me, I'll make you a good wife. Come follow me, I'll make you holier. Come follow me, I'll make you more righteous. Come follow me, I'll make you good. No. When Jesus called his first four disciples, he said, come follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men. It has always been our calling. It has always been our calling to shed light to this darkened world. This world is dying. A lot of your friends, a lot of your relatives, they're into illicit relationships, and they're gonna head for hell. And you're called to be the salt and the light of this world. Interestingly, we're gonna end. The church, as I said kanina, in Acts chapter 19, the church was really growing powerfully. The miracles after miracles are happening. And if you look down, yung ending na to, alam niyo, hindi niyo na naman to alam, dahil hindi nga kinibabasa ng Bible, may ending to, nasa Revelation. Ha? May book pala Revelation? Oo, meron, nasa dulo yon. Okay. Yung Revelation chapter 2, pinakita ni John, this was like 40 or based on some theologians, 30 to 50 years after the church was started, ito yung ending ng church. Remember, they started strong. They started talaga powerfully, miracles after miracles. But look what happened at the ending. Revelation chapter 2, verse 2, I know your deed, this was Jesus telling John to write this to the Ephesian church. I know your deeds, your hard work, and your perseverance. Wow. Jesus was commending the Ephesian church after 40 or 50 years of being established. I know that you cannot tolerate wicked men, that you have tested those who claim to be apostles but are not, and have found them false. Next verse. You have persevered. Wow. Sabihan ka ni Jesus na ganito, yung church natin, yung victory, you have persevered, have endured hardship for my name, and have not grown weary. If you look at this picture, there's nothing wrong with this picture, right? But look at the next verse. Yet I hold this against you. If there's someone na meron kang against, na merong holding something against you, better make sure hindi si God yun. Magkaroon ka na ng atraso sa misis mo, okay lang yun, maayos yun, i-shopping mo lang yun, maayos yun eh. Merong something sa iyo yung kabarkada mo, okay lang yun. Eh, barkada, bayaran mo lang kung ano yung utang mo. May hold something sa yung pusa mo, tadyakan mo lang yun, di ba? Pag pusa, natadyakan lang yun. Hindi, huwag yung mga bata, ano. So, sabi ni Pastor, tadyakan doon. But better make sure it's not God. And God was telling the Ephesian church, I hold this against you. And what's that? You have forsaken your first love. Suddenly, the Ephesian church started strong and suddenly, they're so self-absorbed. Naging rutinary lahat. Naging self-focused lahat. Pero on the inside, they lose the heart. They no longer love those people that God loves. Those people that God sent His Son to die for, they no longer love them. They became so focused on them, they forget about their first love. Nawala na yung honeymoon stage. You see, a picture of first love, anybody here, if I ask you, what is the tallest mountain in the world? Taas nyo kamay nyo kung alam nyo. Tallest mountain in the world. Ay nako, talaga ay magtaas ng iba. The tallest mountain in the world is? Everest. Okay, next question. What's the second tallest mountain? Wala nakakaalam. Who's the first man to step on the moon? Of course, Armstrong. Who's the second man? Walang magpakialam sa second place. Hello. We're only after the first place. Who's the first? And God was telling them, I don't care kung mahal mo ko down the road. But the thing is, you don't love me anymore and you forget about your first love. You stop reading your Bible. You stop praying. Alam niyo yung passion when you first encountered God. Where were you noong una mo nakilala si God? Because Paul was telling this church, Revelation chapter 2, verse 5, sabi dito, remember therefore where you have fallen. They used to be so strong. And here, John, writing what Jesus is telling him, sabihin mo sa mga Ephesian church, pagbibigyan ko sila. Ang una nilang gawin is to remember. Remember, nasan ka ba dati mula nung pinulot ka? Some of you here, you need to ask this question. Where were you before you met Christ? Saan papunta yung relationship niyo mag-asawa before you met Christ? Saan papunta yung addiction mo before you met Christ? Saan papunta yung pornography thing mo before you met Christ? Saan papunta yung relationship mo with your rebellious son before you met Christ? Ano yung condition mo physically before you met Christ? And when you met Christ, He intervened in your history, in your life. And looking back where you are right now, compare now, where were you? You have to always remember. You won't appreciate the good news unless you know the bad news, right? Titingnan mo, doon ka galing, pero gumagapang ka pabalik doon. You keep on sinning and sinning. Ay, hindi anak dyan, kakakanta kinuha eh. That's why I send in my son to die for you, to give you that grace. Why you keep on coming back to death? Doon nga kita binuhay from there. Remember, and next thing sinabi ni God, repent and do the worst you did at first. Remember and repent. Lord, I'm sorry. I forget about you. Remember that movie 50 First Dates? Si Adam Sandler, every day of his life, he has to renew, remember, restart all over again because that's a picture of a very first date. That's a picture of a first love. Kinikilig ka, first time kayo nagkakilala ng misis mo, yung future misis mo. And you have to renew that. And the next thing is redo. Redo. Repeat those things that you did for me when we first met. Because you have already forgotten everything. Ephesians have all the forms, they have all the looks of a pious, religious church. But something is lacking, it's the heart. And some of you need to hear this. You call yourself a Christian and yet you're not living a life of love. There's such so much unforgiveness in your heart. You forgot that God has already forgave you. You received the forgiveness that God has given to you. And it's hard for you to forgive your relative. Hello? That's why we need to hear this. Every day when you get out of this room, when you go to your offices tomorrow, when you go to your house tomorrow, to this evening, better make sure you're living a life of love. And check your heart. Am I loving this person because I want to give or I want to get?